It's not to walk, not run. Anyway, my name is Gwendolyn Sissac. My friends call me Gwen.
Spell it for them that don't know you.
G-W-E-N-D-O-L-Y-N-S-I-S-S-A-C.
Thank you.
And I was reading the 23rd Psalm, and I did some research on the 23rd Psalm.
All right.
And the 23rd Psalm is concerning David. And we don't know, let me pray first. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, Lord Jesus, for giving me this opportunity to stand before you, Lord Jesus. Father God, I'm asking you to let the Holy Spirit use my voice and me, Lord Jesus. And Lord, if anything in me that's not like you, I'm asking you to take it out. Let me speak your word, Father God. Let the angels encamp around me, Father God. And Lord, I'm asking you to bless everyone that's in this place today, Lord Jesus. Lord, I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' name. So, the 23rd Psalm, nobody knows when David wrote the 23rd Psalm. It could have been when he was going through with his son Absalom. And it could have been after then. But, you know, he was going through a lot of stuff with Absalom, his son. But his son wanted to kill him and, you know, do things from it. And I think David was running, hiding and running from him, you know, because he didn't want to hurt his son. You know, when you have children, you don't want to hurt your children, so you just try to walk away from it. And David was crying out when he said, "The Lord is my shepherd." Yeah. David knew he had a relationship with God. He already knew this because God had already told him he was a man after his own heart. And it said, "And I shall not want." That's the source of your needs. When you crying out to God for something, you say, "Lord, you know, help me." You know, you're crying out for a source of your needs. And it said, and two, it said, "He maketh me lie down in green pasture." That's plenty of rest and contentment. Yeah. Sometimes when we get weary in our bodies and things, you know, and you're crying out to God, God gives you that rest. He gives you that contentment, you know, so you can have that, and you know who you believe in, you know who you trust in. And it says, "It leadeth me beside the still water." That's a cool and peaceful and refreshment. When God give you that peace and that cool, that refreshment, you feel it all on the inside of you. That's God working for you. And three, it said, "He restores my soul." That's provision and healing. When you need healing, you call on the Lord for your provision, your healing. And for his name's, "He leads me in the path of righteousness." That's leadership and guidance in following God's will. Whatever God's will is, Lord, I'm going to follow your will. Whatever your will is, Lord.
Hallelujah.
And for he maketh his name, for his name's sake, he gives me high purpose for life. For his name's sake, mm-hmm. We have high purpose of life. "And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death," that's about testing in the darkest valley. When you're going through something, it's only a test, but God brings you out of it.
Amen.
"And I will fear no evil." That's knowing you are protected, even in your lowest hour.
Yes.
You know, no matter what you're going through, God is protecting you. He's there for you. And let's see. "For thou art with me." That's constant faithfulness of the shepherd. When God is with you, that's constant faithfulness, that the shepherd is there. He's there walking with you. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. That's God's protection against the enemy. When the enemy comes up against you and you call on the Lord, God comes in and he intercedes for you. Amen.